Moving over to the left side.
fill an unforgiving minute with 60 seconds worth of distance run. Yours is the earth and everything that's in it. And, which is more, you'll be a man, my son. Thank you.
The last reason I came up here state, or juvenile. Out of these 20 people, or 2.3 million, 76.6 will recidivate. Now, I ain't good at math, but that's a high number. That's more than half. It comes to the fact that how do we fix this? How do we help incarcerated individuals not recidivate, not commit another crime? How do we help them be successful for not just now, but after? For me, this has been education. This is education. Studies have proven that post-secondary education helps reduce recidivism and also helps with employment when getting released to the streets. The same thing, education is connected to the way people view themselves, the way a youth or just an individual sees themselves, whether that be a positive image or a negative. According to beer.org, incarcerated individuals who participate in post-secondary educational programs are 48% less likely to recidivate. So if that's the case and all these statistics are out, why haven't we changed it? We should not have been the first cohort, even though I'm glad that we are, you know, it's an exception when the guys are too, but hey, we are feeling it, but it should not have took this for it to become body of the law. So I just, you know, again, want to congratulate you guys. Hopefully we will be that cohort that changes the way that people, incarcerated people at least, view education and view the schools. So thank you. I'm Mondrell Robertson.
You know, I was in prison, police. Y'all gave me hope, so I just want to say thank you.